instruction from platform. But another idea of working with slabs that came out of mold making when I was doing bond casting, we used to do a lot of, you make the mother form, and then you make a plaster mold, or you do a rubber and plaster mold off of that. And press molding, Christian was doing some press molding over angel wings yesterday into a mold, and that mold may have been originally designed to slip cast in because it was has registration marks on it. Put it together, you fill it up with slip, and the slip absorbs in the plaster and dries, and you open up, you take the wings out. The most interesting thing about molds, for the most part, at least for me, is the making of the mold, making the first piece of the mold. I get bored really quickly with the pieces that are coming out of the mold because I like my work to change and evolve. And it should be, I think, thought of as a tool to make parts for something. You know, it's not like you could give a mold to somebody and say, okay, make these parts, and they're going to look like almost like the same as the pieces you're making. And it occurred to me at some point that I really didn't need to have a plaster mold that I'm pushing clay into. And the other thing that kind of bothered me a little bit is the face of the clay that I was working on was the inside of the pot. So I'm working on this face when it's being pushed into the plaster mold. And the piece that's up against the plaster is the piece of the object of the pot that I'm presenting to the viewer. And there just was something wrong with that for me. So,
is that burnished that it's so shiny?
That is burnished. I thought about the idea that really all you need with clay, because it's a tensile material and it will be subject to gravity and you can form clay easily, all you really need is just a perimeter support, a support shape for any given form. And by that, for instance, this was a triangular box form. If I wanted to do this as a box form, all I really need to do is take clay. And I can line up this pretty good. I can line up my pattern. I'm looking at it before. If I didn't like it, I could shift this a little bit and shift that over, shift that around. I can bump this way down to that form. I have a sock that's filled with sand or something like that, but I don't think I need it for this. But I can take the sock and push the clay down to that form a little bit. The other thing I can do is put my finger on the back of these ridges and just stretch the ridges up.